My interest in addiction began with a job that I worked at after I graduated from Florida Atlantic University. Working at a substance abuse treatment facility was a very impactful and sobering experience. My name is Randy Ellis, and I study substance abuse, behavioral neuroscience, and computational biology. Substance abuse is a disease of brain plasticity. When someone consumes a drug, the experience of consuming the drug and the effects of the drug itself change the brain and how it's wired. So learning how to reverse those changes is crucial to developing new treatments for substance abuse. And that's where the Allen Brain Observatory dataset comes in such great effect. It gives a very in-depth and comprehensive characterization of the visual system, unlike anything that's ever been seen before. So what we did with the Brain Observatory data is look at the responses in one area of the brain to natural images, and from those responses decide what image caused those responses. And understanding the visual system is important for understanding addiction because vision is very important for the process of addiction. When someone is trying to quit smoking, sees somebody smoking a cigarette, that can be very triggering in terms of craving and can lead to relapse. So understanding how information is processed in the visual system is a really good starting point for understanding overall brain functioning and develop novel treatments for substance abuse. The Allen Institute's resources are extremely valuable for multiple domains in science because they attack several issues at many different scales, all of which are relevant to the advancement of biomedical research. We really have to cure substance abuse because it's a growing issue in society and it's killing more people every single day. Neuroscience is making advances on many different fronts in terms of genetics, in terms of brain imaging, that will allow us to understand what happens when someone becomes addicted to a drug of abuse, why some people are more prone to the process, and how we can best treat it. I really hope that we can cure this problem in the next 10 or 20 years.